before boarding the train. The train station is quiet, but there are some hunches of hesitation, perhaps because of those they will leave behind or where they will arrive. And they will watch the moon still waxing over the mountains, coconut groves, or the still dark plains which perhaps will not be cultivated or tilled again, despite the promise of homecoming. They gain resolve, for the rumbling of the coming train is still faint, and its whistling a whisper. It is still far, far still, but there is fear or ache for the last embrace or kiss of the beloved. But once the trees filter the sheen of the train, which sparks the fruit bats to flutter, the feet stir and they hold on to their luggage, and also their breasts, which are more laden with weight. Spouse, child, sibling, friend, memories and one's own home. And when the train comes, as it nears the platform, the skin changes. It becomes like gold, the visage sparkles like a painted joy. Perhaps looking at the direction one assumes is so distant, and then the acquiescence. Next will be the borrowed embraces, or tears that will only fall now. Goodbye, till next time. And the engine merges with its deafening whistle.